Hadith is reported by both Bukhari and Muslim. So that hadith is called what? It's sahih hadith, so it's authentic hadith. Okay? If they agree, both Bukhari and Muslim, they both report it, it's sahih hadith. If Bukhari alone reports, we still call it sahih. If even Muslim reports it, we still call it sahih. We'll find some exceptions, but in general, Bukhari and Muslim, their books are called sahih Bukhari and sahih Muslim. Okay? So let's get to today's hadith. Hadith number 2. So first what we'll do is we will read the Arabic part. We will read the Arabic part, and I'm glad that most of you have pens and pencils today. So you can write in your book, inshallah. So just check the harakat. If they have, if it is a kasra or dhamma or fatha or that is that. Just make sure that we properly read. So hadith number 2. So go to page 5 of your book. Page 5. عن عمر رضي الله عنه أيضا قال بينما نحن جلوس عند رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم ذات يوم إذ طلع علينا رجل شديد بياض الثياب شديد سواد الشعر لا يرى عليه آثر السفر ولا يعرفه منا أحد حتى جلس إلى النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم فأسند ركبتيه إلى ركبتيه ووضع كفيه على فخذيه وقال يا محمد أخبرني عن الإسلام فقال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم الإسلام أن تشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وأن محمد رسول الله وتقيم الصلاة وتؤتي الزكاة وتصوم رمضان وتحج البيت إن استطعت إليه سبيلا قال صدقت فعجبنا له يسأله ويصدقه قال فأخبرني عن الإيمان قال أن تؤمن بالله وملائكته وكتبه ورسله واليوم الآخر وتؤمن بالقدر خيره وشره قال صدقت قال فأخبرني عن الإحسان قال أن تعبد الله كأنك تراه فإن لم تكن تراه فإنه يراك قال فأخبرني عن الساعة قال ما المسؤول عنها بأعلم من السائل قال فأخبرني عن أماراتها قال أن تلد الأمة ربتها وأن ترى الحفاة العراة العالة رعاء الشاء يتضاولون في البنيان ثم انطلق فلبثت مليا ثم قال يا عمر أتدري من السائل قلت الله ورسوله أعلم قال فإنه جبريل أتاكم يعلمكم دينكم. So it's a little bit long hadith, but it's a hadith that most of you know. Okay? So let's translate it. And Umar radiallahu anhu aydan qal. So on the authority of Umar and Khattab, like the same Sahabi, the same companion that reported the hadith we did yesterday. So in the same person. And Umar radiallahu anhu, may Allah be pleased with him. Aydan. So Aydan means again. So he reported the first hadith. Now he is reporting the second hadith. So when we see Aydan means like this person has come back a second time. Another time. Okay? So Aydan basically means again. So an Umar radiallahu anhu Aydan. Also on the authority of Umar radiallahu anhu, may Allah be pleased with him. قال هسان بينما نحن جلوس عند رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم ذات يوم One day, while we were sitting with the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So that is the term. Bainama, again, if we try to translate word by word, we will lose the meaning. So bainama basically means while we were. Nahnu julusun, while we were sitting. Julus basically means we were sitting. Inda Rasulillah sallallahu alaihi wasallam with the Prophet. May Allah be upon him. May Allah's peace and blessings be upon him. That he opened one day. So that would be if we break it word by word. But let me just translate or interpret the whole phrase. بينما نحن جلوس عند رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم ذات يوم. While we were sitting with the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم one day. So again, Umar, may Allah be pleased with him, is telling us. One day while we were sitting with the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, إذ طلع علينا رجل, so a man appeared upon us. So like the companions were sitting with the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and then just a man appeared upon them. They saw a man. شديد بياض الثياب. So this man had extremely white clothes. So shadid basically means like extreme. And then bayad is white. And then thiyar is the clothes. So shadidu bayad thiyar. So he had extremely white clothes. Shadidu sawad shari. And he had extremely dark hair. So his hair was extremely dark also. لا يرى عليه أثر السفر. So we could not see on him signs of travel. He did not appear to be somebody who was traveling. ولا يعرفه منا أحد. And no one among us knew him. The space here in front. ولا يعرفه منا أحد. And no one among us knew him. حتى جلس إلى النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم until he sat next to the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم فأسند ركبتيه إلى ركبتيه. So he leaned his knees onto the knees of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم ووضع كفيه على فخذيه. And he placed his palms on the thighs, on his thighs, either on the thighs of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam or on his own thighs. وقال, and then the man said, يا محمد, أو محمد, أخبرني عن الإسلام, tell me about Islam. فقال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم, the messenger, may Allah's peace and blessings be upon him, said, Islam is أن تشهد أن لا إله إلا الله, that you testify that there is no deity worthy of worship except Allah, وأن محمد رسول الله, and you testify that Prophet Muhammad is Allah's messenger. وتقيم الصلاة. So number two is you establish the five daily prayers. وتؤتي الزكاة, you pay zakah or charity out of your wealth. وَتَصُومَ رَمَضَان, you fast in the month of Ramadan. وَتَحُجَّ الْبَيْتَ إِنِ اسْتَطَعْتَ إِلَيْهِ سَبِيلًا, also you perform pilgrimage, you visit the Kaaba if you have the means to do so. قَالَ, so the man said, صَدَقْتُ, you have spoken the truth, that means you get the answer. فعجبنا له يسأله ويصدقه. So Umar is saying, we were astonished, we were surprised that this man is asking the question and then he is confirming it as though he already knew the answer. So like you wonder when someone asks you a question, so you may assume that this person does not know the answer and just tell them the answer. But then if they tell you, oh, you are right, But you ask yourself, why were you asking me the question in the first place if you know the answer? So the companions are wondering, this man just asked a question to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And when the Prophet answered the question, he is telling him, you got the answer, you're right. قال, and then the man said again, فَأَخْبِرْنِي عَنِ الْإِيمَانِ. So he's saying to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, tell me about Iman. So what is Iman? قال, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, أَن تُؤْمِنَ بِاللَّهِ. So Iman is to believe in Allah. وَمَلَائِكَتِهِ, to believe in Allah's angels. وَكُتُبِهِ, to believe in Allah's books. وَرُسُولِهِ, to believe in Allah's messengers. وَالْيَوْمِ الْآخِرِ, to believe in the last day of judgment. وَتُؤْمِنَ بِالْقَدَرِ خَيْرِهِ وَشَرِّهِ, and also to believe in the predestination, in the predestination, both the good and the evil. قَالَ صَدَقْتَ, the man again said, you have spoken the truth. And then he said, قَالَ, and then he said, فَأَخْبِرْنِي عَنِ الْإِحْسَانِ, tell me about Ihsan. Like, what is Ihsan? قَالَ أَن تَعْبُدَ اللَّهَ كَأَنَّكَ تَرَاهُ. So Ihsan, so the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, Ihsan is to worship Allah as if you see Him. فَإِن لَمْ تَكُنْ تَرَاهُ, if you do not see Him, فَإِنَّهُ يَرَاكُ, indeed Allah sees you. قَالَ فَأَخْبِرْنِي عَنِ السَّاعَةِ, the man again said, tell me about the hour. The hour basically means the Qiyamah, the day of Qiyamah. When will that be? قال, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam replied and said, مَلْ مَسْئُولُ عَنْهَا بِأَعْلَمَ مِنَ السَّائِلِ. So the one being questioned does not know better than the one questioned. So in other words, that means the Prophet said, I do not know when the hour is going to be. So that's, he just said in a more eloquent way. He said, مَا الْمَسْئُولُ عَنْهَا بِيَعْلَمَ مِنَ السَّائِلِ. The one being questioned does not know any better than the one questioned. So he said, I do not know when the hour is. قَالَ فَأَخْبِرْنِي عَنَ مَارَاتِهَا. And the man said, if you do not know when the hour will be, then can you tell me some of the signs of the day of judgment? قال, the Prophet replied, he just gave like two of them. أن تلد الأمة ربتها. أن تلد الأمة ربتها, is that the slave girl will give birth to her mistress. So I'll come back and explain this later, inshallah. So the first sign the Prophet gave was أن تلد الأمة ربتها. So it is the slave girl to give birth to her mistress. And then the second one is وأن ترى. So you will see الحفات, the barefooted, العرات, the naked, العالة, the poor and the destitute, رعاء الشاة, the shepherds, those who look after sheep and goats, يتضاولون في البنيان, competing in building and constructing tall buildings. ثم انطلق, then the man left. فلبثت مليان. So Umar says, I waited a little bit. ثم قال, and then the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said, يا عمر أو عمر, أتدري من السائل, do you know the guy who was questioning me? قلت, عمر said, I said, الله ورسوله أعلم, Allah and His Messenger know better. So that means I do not know who that man was. قال, the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said, إنه جبريل, then that man was جبريل. أتاكم يعلمكم دينكم, he came to teach you your religion. Let's go back and break it down, inshallah. So those of you who have books, you can look at your book. If you don't have it, I have the mean in the history's life. So an Umar radiallahu anhu aydan qal. So Umar again we said he was the second Khalifa, the second leader of the Muslims. So after the death of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Abu Bakr was the first leader, and then after the death of Abu Bakr, then Umar was the second leader. So Umar is the one reporting this hadith from the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So an Umar radiallahu anhu aydan, on the authority of Umar, may Allah be pleased with him again, قال, he said, بينما نحن جلوس عند رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم ذات يوم. One day while we were sitting with the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم. So in this hadith there is بينما, again we say it's while, نحن is we, جلوس is sitting, عند means close or with, عند رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم ذات يوم, one day. If I break it down word by word, that would be the meaning. So بينما نحن جلوس عند رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم ذات يوم. One day while we were sitting with the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, إذ طلع علينا رجل. So a man appeared before us, or a man came over. So Dala'a basically means when something appears. So a man appeared. So the companions were sitting with the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So as usual, the Prophet is teaching his companions. So they were sitting with the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And then, إِذَ طَلَعَ عَلَيْنَا رَجُلٌ. So a man appeared before us. So again, Umar gives a description of who this man, about this man. So he says, this man is shadidu bayad al-thiyab. So this man has extremely white clothes. So that means his clothes are very clean. They're very white. Shadidu shawad al-sha'r. And his hair is so dark. La yura alayhi athar al-safar. And we did not see him any signs of travel. So like, you know, when someone has been traveling on foot, usually what happens? You see dust on their foot, on their clothes, right? On their feet, there'll be dust. Their clothes will be dust. Their hair will be dust, right? So if you have been walking, traveling by foot. So Umar says, this man who appeared before us, he did not seem as a traveler. He's clothes are very clean and white, and his hair was so dark. So we didn't see any signs of travel on him. And then besides, لا يعرف منا أحد. No one among us knew this man. So he's wondering, this man seems to be just a man from the city, because he does not seem to be a traveler. But again, no one knows among us. No one knows him. No one knows him. So ولا يعرفه منا أحد. So that means no one among us knew him. حتى جلس إلى النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم. So as this man was walking, he went straight to the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, and he sat opposite of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم. So he did not talk to anybody else. As he was walking, he just sat opposite of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم. And then Umar is given a description of the way he sat. فَأَسْنَدَ رُكْبَتَيْهِ إِلَىٰ رُكْبَتَيْهِ. So he leaned or he rested his knees on the knees of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم. وَوَضَعَ كَفَيْهِ عَلَىٰ فَخِدَيْهِ. And he placed his palms on his thighs. So he came to the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, and then like, this is how he sat. So I was sitting here, so this is how he sat. So he rested his knees on the knees of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and then he placed his palms either on his own thighs or on the thighs of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So again, like, this is adab. It shows like the proper way to sit. Okay, when you are sitting with an older person or an older person, so you humiliate yourself, you sit this way. So he rested his knees on the knees of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and he placed his palms on his thighs or on the thighs of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, whichever you explain it.
Wa qala ya Muhammad akhbirni an Islam.
So after he said that format I just described to you, then he started asking the Prophet a question. The first question he asked was, he said, akhbirni an Islam. He said, tell me about Islam. So what is Islam? So then the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam started listing the pillars of Islam. You all know that, right? There are how many pillars of Islam? There are five.
The pillars of Islam are five.
So we listed the five.
فقال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم, the Prophet, may Allah his peace and blessings be upon him, said, Al-Islamu Islam is an tashhada an la ilaha illallah,
to testify
that there is no God worthy of worship except Allah, wa anna Muhammad Rasulullah, and you testify that Muhammad is Allah's messenger.
So this part here.
And then number two is wa tuqima salah is you establish the five daily prayers. Number three, wa tu'ti az-zakah, you give zakah or charity from your wealth. Okay, and then we give to the poor and the needy and the rivers, and so there are eight categories of people that we give zakah. So we did this in our Safina class. Number four is watasuma Ramadan. Then you fast in the month of Ramadan. We fast for how many days?
30
or 29. Yeah. And then number five is watahujjal bayta in istada'ta ilayhi sabila. And then you perform the pilgrimage. You visit the house. When we say the house, that basically means is the Kaaba in Mecca. So watahujjal bayta, so you perform pilgrimage or you visit the Kaaba when in istada'ta ilayhi sabila, if you are able to do so, if you have the means to do so, if you are capable of traveling and you have that amount of wealth to do the Hajj, then it is compulsory upon you once in your lifetime to perform Hajj. So those are the five pillars of Islam. There's the Shahada, which is anta shahada an la ilaha illallah wa anna Muhammadan Rasulullah. Number two, wa tuqima salah. Number three, wa tu'ti az-zakah. Number four, wa tasuma Ramadan. And number five is wa tahujja al-bayta in istata'ta ilayhi sabila. Qala, so the man said, sadaqt, you have spoken the truth. So again, the companions are watching. This is a stranger man sitting by the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam asking him questions. But then now, when the Prophet answers the question, the man says, "Sadaqta, you have spoken the truth." Now, fa'ajabna lahu. So this is Umar speaking. Fa'ajabna lahu. So we wonder, we were astonished, or we were surprised by this man. Yas'aluhu, he is questioning the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, wa yusaddiquhu, and then he is confirming the answer. He is telling him, you have spoken the truth. Okay? So that is Umar saying, me and other companions, we were wondering, like, this man who is asking the question and then confirming the answer, who is he? Like, those answers can only be known by the Prophet. And this man is not the Prophet who is questioning the messenger. So they are like, who could this man be? How come is he knows the answer already? And then قال, and then the man asked another question. He said, فَأَخْبِرْنِ عَنِ iman, tell me about iman. قال, the man said, أَن تُؤْمِنَ بِاللَّهِ, قال the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and said, iman is أَن تُؤْمِنَ بِاللَّهِ, to believe in Allah. So how do we believe in Allah? We believe in the oneness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We believe that Allah is one and unique and there is nothing like Him. All creations need Him and He does not need it. any of his creations. Okay? So you believe in Allah, tu'mina billah. Wa malaikatihi, you believe in Allah's angels. You believe in Allah's angels. Angels are also other creations of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. What do we know about them?
We know
they're neither male nor female. They worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. They do not disobey Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala even for a second. So as human beings, we do mistakes and we sin and then we repent to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But for the angels, they do not disobey Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. لَا يَعْصُونَ اللَّهَ مَا أَمَرَهُمْ وَيَفْعَلُونَ مَا يَأْمُرُونَ. So they do not disobey Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and they do exactly as they are commanded to do by Allah. Okay? They do not sleep, they do not slumber. And in our last class we had, I taught you about 10 of them that we should know their names and their role, right? Can you tell me a name of an angel? Yes, Banya? So, angel Rahman, yes. So what does he do? Yes, the angel in charge of by the gates of the heaven. Yes, Munkar and Nakir. So now you're supposed to start with the first angel, like who is the top, the leader of the angels?
Jibril.
Angel Jibril, yes. Angel Jibril, what is his role? What does he do? Yeah, so he is the one who brings revelations to the prophet. So basically, Angel Jibril is the teacher of the prophets. Okay, any other angel you know? Yes. Raqib and Atid, yes. What do they do? Yeah, they record our deal. So this is those names, yeah. So unto mina billah, wa malaikatihi, so the prophet said, you believe in our angels, wa kutubihi, you believe in the books revealed by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So do you know any books? The Quran, okay, Quran, that is the book given to our Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. That is our book. Now, another book?
Yes.
Injil given to who? Prophet Isa. So Injil basically means the gospel, and then they call it the Bible now, even though it's not the correct one. Okay, so that is the one given to Prophet Isa. Another book you know? Yes, Taha? Zabur, mashallah. Zabur is given to who? Prophet Darul. Yes. Yes. Torah given to Musa. Yes. So the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam answered this question telling, Antumina billah, believe in Allah, wa malaikati, believe in his angels, wa kutubihi, believe in his books, wa rusulihi, believe in Allah's messengers. Okay? You believe in Allah's messengers. In the Quran, there are about 25 names of messengers mentioned. Do you know any? Tell me one messenger, one prophet name. Prophet Muhammad. So, our Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, another name? Prophet Dhul-Kifl. Taha. Prophet Noah. Prophet Muhammad. Yes.
Prophet
Moses. Prophet Shaib. Prophet Yusuf. Idris, yeah. Adam, yeah, so there are about 25 of them mentioned in the Quran. So we are supposed to also believe in Allah's message. We believe in all of them. Like we cannot say, oh, I don't believe in that prophet. No. As a Muslim, we are supposed to believe in all of the messengers sent by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. They may have different ranks in the eyes of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, but for us, we are supposed to believe in all of them. And our Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is the best among all of the messengers of the prophets. So, unto mina billah wa malaikati wa kutubi wa rusuli wal yawmil akhir. Also believe in the day of judgment. So, yeah, see. So believe in the last day, in the day of judgment. So,
yawmil akhir
basically means the last day. So that is the day when all people will stand in front of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and we will be questioned of our actions and our deeds. Okay? So everyone will be accountable for what they do in this dunya. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will question us. If we pass, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will grant us Jannah, and that is what I hope that all of us will get, inshallah ta'ala. And then if our actions are otherwise, then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will have the option of forgiving us or punishing us. Okay? So we have to believe in that last day, that everyone will stand in front of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and then people will either go to heaven or they will go to Jahannam or hellfire. We seek Allah's protection, inshallah ta'ala, from the hellfire. And then the last one is وَبِالْ قَدَرِ خَيْرِهِ وَشَرِّهِ. So you also believe in the predestination, the good or the evil. So everything that happens to you in this dunya is something that has already been prescribed by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Whether it is good or evil, everything that we go through is something that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has already ordained and prescribed for us. So we believe in the qadr. And then the man said, قَالَ صَدَقْتْ. And he said, you have spoken the truth. So he said, you have spoken the truth. And then he moved on to the next question. He said, قَالَ فَأَخْبِرْنِي عَنِ الْإِحْسَانِ. Tell me about Ihsan. See, like at this point, most of you know Islam and Iman, right? The pillars of Islam are five. The pillars of Iman are six. The one we now mentioned. So there is a third concept of our Islamic deen. That's called focus on the spiritual nature. Okay? So you have Islam where you do your salah, your zakah, your hajj, and then you have the Iman, that you have that faith, and then we have Ihsan, it's a higher level. Okay, it's the spiritual level. So he said, فَأَخْبِرْنَا عَنْ إِحْسَانِ. Tell me about Ihsan. Again, Ihsan as an Arabic word, it basically means something good. But now, over here, it has a deeper meaning. Okay? So Ihsan basically means doing good. But in this context, there's something else. Okay? So Ihsan is a third concept of the Islamic religion. We have Islam, Iman, and Ihsan. So the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam replied, قال أن تعبد الله كأنك تراه. So Ihsan means أن تعبد الله, that you worship Allah, كأنك تراه, as if you see him. Okay, so you worship Allah as if you see him. Okay, so like for example, like whenever your parents are watching you, you don't want to do something bad, right? Yeah, because your parents see you. Okay, so you're afraid of them. So here says, "أَتَعْبُدُ اللَّهَ كَأَنَّكَ تَرَاهُ." You worship Allah as if you see Him. فَإِنْ لَمْ تَكُنْ تَرَاهُ. If you do not see Allah, for sure we don't see Allah. So if you do not see Him, فَإِنَّهُ يَرَاهُ. Definitely Allah sees you. So this will give you what? To be conscious of oneself. Okay, so whatever you're doing, in your mind that you know Allah is watching you. Whatever you do, whether it's good or bad, so you have to be self-conscious and remember, okay, am I going to do good? Am I going to do bad? Whatever I do, Allah is watching me. Even though I don't see Him, but He sees me. So He's watching me. So I have to be mindful of my actions. Okay? Whatever I say, whatever I do, because Allah is watching me. So I have to be truthful of the things that I do. I always have to strive to please Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. I have to strive to avoid the wrath and the punishment of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So whatever actions I do, I have to be self-conscious. Okay? So that is what Ihsan is. And ta'budu Allah ka'annaka tarah. We worship Allah as if you see Him. فَإِنْ لَمْ تَكُنْ تَرَاهُ. If you do not see Him, فَإِنَّهُ يَرَاكَ. Allah sees you. And then قال فأخبرني عن الساعة. So the man said, tell me about the hour. The ساعة means tell me about the last day. Tell me about the قيامة. Does anyone know when the قيامة will be?
No.
No one knows. Even the prophets do not know. No one knows when the قيامة, when the last day. Who knows when the قيامة will be? Only Allah. Okay? So if someone tells you, oh, the prophets know when the قيامة is, they're lying. The prophets, the angels, no creation knows when the Qiyamah will be. So when he asked the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, فَأَخْبِرْنِي عَنِ السَّاعَةِ. Tell me about the hour. Tell me about the last day of judgment. What was the answer of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam? He said, "Man al-mas'ulu anha bi'a'lama min as-sa'il." Right? Look at your book. It says, "Man al-mas'ulu anha bi'a'lama min as-sa'il." So, the one being questioned does not know any better than the questioner. So the Prophet basically saying, "I have no clue when the hour is going to be." Okay? So that is knowledge only known by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. No creation knows when the hour is going to be. Even the Prophet replied, "Mal mas'ul anha bi'alama min as-sa'il." So he said, the one questioned about it knows no more than the questioner. The man continued and asked the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, قَالَ فَأَخْبِرْنِي عَنْ أَمَارَاتِهَا. And if you do not know when the hour is going to be, then tell me about some of the signs of that hour. Okay? Then tell me the signs of the hour. قَالَ And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam replied, أَنْ تَلِدَ الْأَمَّةُ رَبَّتْهَا. أَنْ تَلِدَ الْأَمَّةُ رَبَّتْهَا. He said that the slave woman will give birth to her mistress. What does that mean? A slave girl is given birth to her mistress. Okay? So, it has, the scholars gave like multiple interpretations. But I will just take the easiest one that is applicable in our day-to-day lives. So, this basically means that children will be so disobedient to their parents to a point where they treat their mothers as their own slaves. Yeah, so is that happening today? Yes. How many of us yell about mothers? Yeah? Hundreds of, so most of you are not doing it, but like it's something very common. Okay? Disobedience to parents is very rampant nowadays. It's one of the signs of qiyamah. So you will see the children are so disobedient to their parents. You'll find them insulting their parents, yelling at their parents. So that is what this is. Antalidal ammatu rabbata. The slave girl giving birth to the mistress. So that means the child is now the master of the parent. So now the child is the one giving orders to the parent. So because the children are becoming so disobedient to their parents. So that is one sign. So in Somali, we even have that Dashi Hoyadir Dalmada Parte. Dashi Hoyadir Dalmada Parte. Exactly that this is. And Talida Amma to Rabbata. So that means you're telling your parents, "Oh, you know nothing, I know better than you. So you need to listen to me." Instead of the child listening to the parent, now it is the opposite. The children want to be the commanders, want to be the masters of their parents. Oh, you tell your mom, "Oh, mom, this is not how you should give birth. Oh, you should give birth this way." Is that proper? No, no. So we are getting to that point. Okay? Even though most of us, our Muslim children, alhamdulillah, are 90% good and obey their parents. But like when you look at the non-Muslim communities, there's no respect given to the parents. No respect of the Day of Judgment. So we are getting close. And then the next one, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, "Wa antara," so you will see, "al-huffatir, al-urratir, al-alata ri'a ash-shai, yatadawaruna fil bunyan." So another sign of the Qiyamah is you will see the barefooted ones, the naked people, the destitute and the poor, those who look after the goats and who are the shepherds, they look after the goats and sheep. Now all of a sudden they become wealthy, they accumulate a lot of money, and now they are building tall buildings. And this example is also very alive today. One of the signs the Prophet ﷺ gave is you find the poor and the naked and those who used to look after sheep and goats, all of a sudden are competing in building tall buildings. ثُمَّنْ ضَلَبْ. And the man who was questioning the Prophet left. فَلَبِثْتُ مِلْيَنْ. So Umar says, we wait a little bit. ثم قال أنه Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said, يا عمر عمر أتدري من إسرائيل؟ Do you know the questioner? Do you know that man was questioning me? قلت عمر says, I said, الله ورسوله أعلم. Allah and His Messenger know better. That means Umar says, I do not know the answer. I do not know who that man was. قال أنه Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said, فإنه جبريل. That man was جبريل. أتاكم يعلمكم دينكم. He came to teach you your religion. So here we see Jibril, Angel Jibril, who was the teacher of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, sometimes came to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam in the form of a man. So Allah gave him that power to change. So Angel Jibril sometimes visited the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam in the form of a man, and this was a couple of times. So the other companions did not know who this stranger man was, and then finally, the Prophet told them who that man was. That man was Angel Jibril, who came to teach them about their religion. He taught them about Islam, Iman, and Ihsan. Okay? So, Prophet time.